he was called Curtis Rush. I don't know why he was called Curtis Rush, but he was. And he was singing all sorts of dodgy songs in working men's clubs.
I'd taken this tape in and a photograph and seen Nigel and our manager. And I'd say, oh, I write songs as well. And he kind of looked at me with that face of, oh, right, another one who writes songs.
However, so impressed was Nigel by Curtis's demo that he immediately earmarked him as the head of his new brainchild, the Take That family.
He's a very solid character, Gary. He'll make a fantastic father. When I decided to do the boy band thing, the first person that came to mind was Mark Owen, because whenever he came in the office, all the girls loved him. Jason and Howard, they were always there to appeal to the older woman. Robbie was the wisecracker. He's such a huge talent. He's like a mad professor.
Nigel had remortgaged his house and made a record with them called Do What You Like, made this sort of risque video, and it was great, and this is what sort of started it all off.
While video evidence suggests Gary was rightly proud of his Jelly Belly, the first three singles flopped.
We were about to be dropped from our record label. It was that bad. We really had to twist their arm into them releasing another record. And we'd recorded a cover version of an old Tavares record, Only Takes a Minute Girl.
Now cross your feet and leap out. Now turn.
It was nothing more than sheer hard work that, you know, the five of us put in to make that record happen. And we realised this was it. We're going to have a hit with this record. And of course, once you have a hit, it's a lot easier from then on. I could love you, yeah, build my world around you.
Never leave you till my life is done. Baby, I want you
come. Take That were the first of their kind, and you just couldn't get away from that. Massive, absolutely massive. Hysteria. All I do each night is pray.
The strength of Take That was not really ever in any one member. It was in the sum total of all of them put together.
There was somebody for everybody in Take That.
I think what Back For Good did was it proved that Gary could actually write to order, because we were looking for a track that could launch the band in America.
And it was kind of a cocky time for me as well. So I can do that. Yeah, I can do that, no problem. And I went away and wrote this song, Back For Good. I guess now it's time for me to give up. I think it's time. And then it was just stand back and watch. You know, number one in 26 countries or so. It was just unbelievable, the success of that record. That was the moment, I think, when we all realised, well, that is it. We're going to watch carefully now and decide when to split up. Gotta leave it all behind now. Whatever I said, whatever I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good.
But one member was to take an early bath. Our Robbie, who acrimoniously split from the band in July 1995.
He very cleverly got the sympathy vote by saying I was in this horrible machine that made me millions of pounds and turned me into a star and gave me the opportunity to do what I've always wanted to do, but it's been awful. I mean, what bollocks.
The shell-shocked Fab Four continued touring, but their work lacked a certain direction. The end was just around the corner.
I think Gary Barlow instigated the split of Take That finally. He'd had enough. He wanted to go off and write his own solo album.
We knew we'd had enough. The Greatest Hits was coming out. It was just all perfect. It was just time.
The future of the pop group Take That is unclear after newspaper reports that they're planning to split up.
I organised a press conference, and I think to the moment those boys stood on that stage and said we're splitting, I don't think anyone actually believed they were going to do it.
Unfortunately, the rumours are true. From today, is no more.
Take That has split.
What question?
I don't believe it.
Take That split up.
Young people all over the country felt genuinely devastated. It really is, for them, like losing a member of the family, so they're going through the same feelings of bereavement.
We've come a long way, but we're not too sure.
Wars are being waged all over the world and the country is in mourning for a pop band. That is the power of a successful band. It's extraordinary. It's extraordinary. I mean, they still go to the loo, you know.
We'd made it. We'd done 6 years together, and we were kind of... We all got on so well that I'd have hated it to have been a situation where someone would have had a fight with somebody. That would have ruined it for me.
Of course, there'd already been one fight, and the anti-Barlow had already embarked on the rock and roll lifestyle that would make him a bigger star than ever.
He is a tortured artist. He's tortured himself. You know, drink, drugs, nights out, the wrong women, whatever. That's what makes Robbie a rock star. He's not a pop star now, he's a rock star. He's been promoted.
Meanwhile, Mark's solo career is on hold. Jason Orange is acting, Howard Donald is resting, and Gary's enjoying his royalties.
I loved being in a band because of the contact I had with people every day, and I kind of miss that.
They went through probably what most people would only go through in a lifetime, in that 5 years. And I think the sooner all five of them get back together and put everything behind them and become friends again, then they can all get on with their lives.